beautiful thing to me about the scientific method is you, as you said, you pose a hypothesis. There's a problem. You don't know the answer. You don't know what it works. You pose a hypothesis. I think it's this. And then you design experiments to test that. And so the story goes. And if the experiment supports it, fine. If it doesn't, you reject that hypothesis and move on. Except very rarely does it work that way. Most of the time, your experiment doesn't really give you, you know, well, sometimes it does, but sometimes it gives you sort of an answer. You know, you sort of understand. And anyway, you keep going down. But at the end of the day, that's essentially how it works. But what the part that's left out of that is that you can't ever really prove anything that way. You can design experiments and that give you an answer that's consistent with your hypothesis, but it may also be consistent with another hypothesis. And that's what you've got to do. Or even the opposite of your hypothesis that I do, and I teach everybody in my lab, the idea that you can prove something with science, just get rid of that. All you can do is fail to disprove. And if you try as hard as you can to disprove your hypothesis and you can't, and nobody else can either, then probably it's right, maybe, you know. We'll see, you know. But, I mean, that's what it is getting rid of that ambiguity that allows you to really, you know, get someplace. And to do that is hard, and it takes a long time. But you've got to just look at your data, you know. And you can't just say, I'm going to look at it and it's told me this or it's told me this about my hypothesis. Most of the time, you'll get a partial answer, but there's some answers in there. And you need to just say, what else is it telling me? You know, you need to, that's what I try to teach people. Don't just say, oh, it's this or this. Now let's move on. You say, no, what's there? What's the data? What is the data really? Look at every facet of that. Look at it like it's a stone and you hold it up, you know, and you look at it this way and you look at it that way and get everything out of it you can, and then experiments come from that, and that's the fun of it, you know.